jour de différence dans toute une existence. Ça n'a pas d'importance, semble-t-il, et pourtant la vie vous semble grise. 24 heures suffisent pour qu'on la trouve exquise. Que faut-il simplement?
In our lives. Now, first we've got to thank our live band. Thank you, live band. Wow, some just beautiful live music there.
Before we get into it, how good was Shavua?
Oh, well, I think I had a few too many cheesecakes, if you get my drift. Well, Simi, before we start, we better check in with all the muds.
Roll call!
Yep.
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 Yep. Yep.
Yes, sir.
Present.
Here.
Here.
Yo.
Yep.
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 Here. Yep.
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 Present.
Present.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah.
Present.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
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 Present.
Yeah.
Yep.
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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
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 Yeah.
Present.
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 Yep.
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 Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm here. Yeah.
Well, how about that 100% Pedro's record once again?
Let's get right into it. I think it's time to check on Tully in the park.
I think it is. Without further ado, it's time for Tully's Tackless.
Here she is now,
Tully Borowick.
And this is my Tackless. Today, I'm at Caulfield Park, the place where everyone seems to be. Let's go say hi to some of my friends.
Whoa! Ash, Ronnie, I had no idea you guys would be here.
I had no idea the lady bunch hung out here.
Why not share a cup of tea or a cup of coffee?
Green tea!
First one to go down, Ronnie, after doing barely anything, has succumbed to fatigue. It's important, kids, to make sure exercise is consistent, otherwise this can happen.
Park for all the cute dogs.
How about you?
I recently found out skipping is twice as quick as walking. Let's have a little fun today. also at the park a great sporting initiative, like this cricket pitch. That was awesome!
Hi, I'm Ranger P.
Guys, we've got a chalik spot. How are you, my good sir?
I am good. How are you?
Do you know why they even filmed for the Bonet show? How exciting is that?
Great.
Oh, that is so good. Keeping well?
Keeping
fit?
Yeah. I've got my friend coming here. He's more talkative than I.
Everyone subscribe to
the Bonet show.
Subscribe and you'll get internal good luck.
Thank you.
Never go in the grass, too muddy, way too muddy.
Well, guys, I'm with Eddie Lifting, the Eddie Lifting here at Cornfield Park. Eddie, did you run here?
I walked here from my car. Very important for when you come to Cornfield Park, great running playlist. And I suggest on, I've got a great running playlist on Spotify, it's called Workout Run. Search me up, Eddie Lifting 456.
Eddie, what's your favourite Beyonce song?
Oh, it's got to be Put a Ring on It.
Tell us about a bit of what you're wearing, Eddie. What are you wearing today?
So this is sort of the winter outfit. Yeah, it's really, really cold. I'm very into skins, but I couldn't find it in the wardrobe. So I just went for the tracksuit and the Nike runners. They're absolutely unbelievable.
Fascinating stuff, Edward. Now, I understand you made a little rap for us today on the show.
He's sending that around once his official album debuts. We're going to have to wait for copyright to come through, if that's okay.
I have to call you back. No, Beyonce, I love you. No, you're the sweetest. No, I'll give you a call back. Thank you. Okay, bye. Yeah, bye.
Wow. I mean, it's not often that I get to come to the park, but when I do, I'm sure to relax and enjoy myself. As I'm sure you just heard, my life is very stressful. If it's whether I'm, you know, eating or sleeping, it's full of stuff. And I come to the park, I think if you do relax, I think that is an essential criteria during this crisis. Make sure you're eating, sleeping, drinking, well. That's Tully Couples for this week. We'll see you in 2 weeks.
Oh, the buzz. Figures never disappoints. And wasn't Caulfield Park looking nice?
Yeah, you just never know who you're going to run into over there.
It's such an unpredictable place, and what a day.
Look like such a beautiful day.
Now, it's funny you say that, because kids, I know you want to go to Caulfield Park, but one thing you should always do is make sure the weather is nice. You want to go see it's raining, and that's why we have our man, Wilbur the Weatherman, on the scene to let you know whether the weather's going to be nice enough for you to go to Caulfield Park.
Wilbur? Are you with us?
I have no idea how passionate everybody is about the weather. Like, I'm just getting texts, emails, calls all day long. People just love... we're off. Hello, we're back with the weather here. This is Wilbur again. It's an honour to be bringing you the weather again. Listen, it's cold. You're going to see a variety of thick clouds and thin clouds, rainy clouds, dry clouds. That's just the way the cookie crumbles at the moment, I reckon. We've received a lot of communication from the fans this week, from the viewers. And the main question that I've been getting is, how is it that I'm so accurate with my forecasting of the weather every week? And so to all you viewers out there, I just wanted to tell you that it certainly does take a lot of hard work, a lot of research, a lot of late nights, but big part of it is also just trusting your gut, you know? That's the only way that you're going to get the weather right. Well, that's another weather session for me here, Wilbur, and the rest of the weather team. Just wanted to thank you all out there for all the support. Keep up the good work. Don't forget to rug up. And I'll see you next time.
Thank you, Wilbur, for that unbelievable report once again, showing us who is the best weatherman in town. Now, on to our next segment.
Last week, we gave Ari Goldberg the task of becoming the next James Corden, and boy did he deliver.
Now it's time for you to fasten your seatbelts. It's time for another episode of Mudpool Karaoke.
Okay, this is lovely. I'm so excited to go on the drive.
I'm also excited.
What a world. I'll be honest. My life has changed minimally because of it.
Go on.
As in, like... I sit at home and I do my uni stuff, and just instead of schlepping to Monash, I've done it online.
Like, I thought I was an extrovert, but maybe I'm actually an introvert.
Fact about me and my family is that I'm a big into music.
Right.
I know everyone likes music. Everyone does like music, but like I it's a real passion. Like, I love like researching bands or whatever. Like, yeah, and my family as well. Unfortunately, none of us have the talent to justify that level of passion. Can't sing, can't do anything. But, and I have my iPod, and right. I think I'm the only person that I know in the world that still uses an iPod.
Right.
Nearing about 10,000 songs.
Oh, gee, that is quite a collection.
Yeah, and so I brought my iPod along.
Wonderful.
And I thought, wait, we
should play some. I assume, is it classics? Is it?
So it's everything and anything. By the lightning, me, we're never alone, never alone, no, no. Come on, come on, moon a little faster. Come on, come on, I wanna hear you whisper. Come on, come on.
Because you're doing media and engineering.
Yeah.
How do they blend or not?
Not at all.
I
mean, they're comically different.
Yeah, well, that's what you would assume from the outset.
So, like, today, take anything, like engineers, like, when we're walking to classes, they stick to the paths.
Right.
The concrete is their salvation, grass is toxic.
Right.
Okay? Once I move over slightly to the Menzies building, the art students, we'll walk on the grass, it gets there quicker.
Shoes off, a bit more.
Whatever happens, doesn't matter. Foxtel very kindly, because of isolation, opened up the movies packages for free.
Right.
And it has been marvellous.
Really? Any good movies that you could
basically
recommend?
Almost a movie every 3 days at least. I've been
Wow, okay.
So over the weekends I'd watch one Saturday night.
So how many movies?
Saturday night I watch two movies.
Love, love me do. You know I love you. I'll always be true. So please, love me do.
Oh, I've been watching a lot.
Watching TV and movies for film studies. No, this sounds wonderful. Any recommendations? Any classics you like? Oh, if you haven't watched.
No, so exactly. So there's a lot of movies out there that I'm quite embarrassed to admit that I've never seen.
Okay.
But because I've never had, I don't download movies.
Right.
I'm quite against it.
You're a video easy, video blockbuster.
I used to be. That's the dream. Last week, for example, just off the top of my head, like I had never seen Silence of the Lambs.
Okay.
Because also I don't do scary movies.
No. I'm not big on scary movies.
No, I don't get people. Why would you want to be scared?
Well, yeah. How come you watched The Joker?
Oh, I love that. Not forgetting, but people would be like, oh, like, this is the most amazing Joker we've ever seen. Again. Okay, just remember, Heath Ledger was pretty awesome too. I will defend the Dark Knight till the day I die. Best chorus ever! Jealousy, turning saints into the sink, swimming through scent lullabies, choking on your alibis, but it's just the price I pay. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes, 'cause I miss the bright side. Woo!
I love this song.
I've been really wanting to get into woodwork.
Okay. Is there a particular reason or...?
I just think I'd really enjoy woodwork.
Okay.
And I think it's a fantastic hobby.
To, like, are we talking big scale things like tables and chairs and
right
cabinets?
Right now, my aim is just coasters.
Before you say another word, Zavair, before you chain me up like a slave again, listen to me, there is something I must do.
Oh, I only got Facebook 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah, you got Facebook?
Yeah, just before tonight. My sister forced me. Wow. She made the account for me. Another example of that. And now I appreciate it because it's good for birthdays.
It is.
And memes. Palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But on the surface, he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud. He opens his mouth, but the words just won't come out. He's choking hard, everybody's choking now. It's yourself and the music, the moment you want it. You better never let it go. Go, only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, yo.
You had any doubts that Ari Goldberg was the next James Corden? Then, boy, you're looking silly right now.
I reckon Benji Kalkoff could be the next Eminem.
Look, if you asked me that 10 minutes ago, I would have said absolutely no chance. But after watching him spit some fire, boy, have I been turned. That guy's got some serious bars. And we're having a good time on The Banana Show, as always. But you know what? We've got to cut to the ad break. So we'll see you back on The Banana Show just after this.
Good grammar and spelling are important. But if you want to write essays that inspire, messages that forge brighter connections, and emails that get the job done, you need to think about more than just grammar and spelling. This sentence is grammatically correct, but it's wordy and hard to read. It undermines the writer's message, and the word choice is bland. Much better. Grammarly works where you work, on your computer or your phone. Imagine what you could do with the secrets of the world's best writers at your fingertips, anytime you need them. Are you ready to give it a try? Installation is simple and free. Visit Grammarly.com today.
Welcome back to The Banana Show. It's good to still have you with us.
Boy, do we have a big surprise for you.
You bloody bet you're excited for this one. It's going to be a big one.
Enjoy.
Hey, I'm Moti, Iska.
Hi.
And we are the producers?
Yeah, producers.
This is how, I'm sorry, it's the English, you know.
Look, we have so much that is going on. Like, we have Bet Midrash, we have Shiurim, we have Tikkun Leh. But, you know, something's missing.
We arrived here like a year ago, and we heard about something that used to happen ages ago. Something amazing, special, different, that Pnei used to do. And they're missing at a moment.
And I don't know what.
Halacha Genie! So today we are looking for our new Halacha Genie.
We're looking for someone strong, smart, charismatic.
So I really hope we're gonna find our next Halacha Genie here.
Come in! Hello. Please say your name and your shevet.
Hi, I'm Menucha, year three boys.
So I understand you are a year three boy.
No. I'm the madrucha of year three boys.
Oh, I got you. So you are a year three boy.
Okay, let's start. Why don't we start with your favorite mitzvah?
There's so many. I couldn't choose a favorite mitzvah.
Interesting.
Why do you think you should be the halacha genie?
Sorry, what? Isn't this to replace Simi as the B'nai show host? Sorry, I thought after last week's performance you wanted someone new? Good luck with the B'nai show.
Next!
Hi, I'm Yasmin. I'm a year 9 mad, and I'm here for the Halacha Genie auditions, obviously.
So, why do you think the position of the Halacha Genie is important?
Well, everyone has questions, and I'm definitely the one to give the answers. Halachically.
Yaz, can you tell me, please, what is your favorite mitzvah?
My favorite mitzvah by far is tzion. I love keeping up with halacha whilst being fashionable. BTW, midi skirts are in right now.
Midi? What is... Maza midi?
Nirali kamo midi mouse.
Okay, yes. So we're just gonna like run through a scenario.
Here's little Benny. Little Benny doesn't know which bracha to make.
So I really, really want to eat this banana, but I'm not sure what bracha should I make. Help me! Oh my god, Halacha Gini, can you help me?
Oh, this is a tricky one. It might be confusing, but it's actually Brei Pri Ha'adama. Well done!
Yasmin, thanks so much, that was great. We're gonna call you back soon.
I know you will.
Oh my god.
She's the one.
Next!
Is it so what is your name and Shevet?
Hold on, it's just a really good part. He split the sea.
Wow, Moshe means he's your favorite character from the Torah.
Most people are like Team Moshe because, you know, he spoke to God and saw the burning bush. But I feel like I'm a bit more Team Aaron. Like, he loved peace and he pursued peace. And I think that's more my vibe.
Yeah, exactly like it said in Masechet Avot. Be like Aaron's students. Love the peace and chases the peace.
Okay, so it's the eighth night of Hanukkah. How many candles are you going to light?
I'm going to have to go with 9.
According to Bet Hillel, nice. But 8... Don't you mean 8?
Oh, 9. You can't forget the Shamash.
Turn down for what? Turn down for what?
Next!
So I'm Eddie, but people call me HG.
What's HG?
Halacha Gini.
Why do you think you have what it takes to be Halacha Gini?
Well, firstly, it all starts with the outfit. So I've got 3 different identities here. We've got modern, orthodox, and the Strimals, obviously Haredi. Also got a bit of secularism here.
So what experience do you have to this role?
So, I have a bachelor of 2 years in yeshiva, and I'm currently studying a master's, currently 5-year course of how to cuff your pants, your Shabbat pants. Very important in terms of being a classy halacha gini. Mati, you can see, so this is a little bit high raised, just on top of the Bunsen. You might be able to roll it up a little bit.
Okay, so we're just going to do a bit of like word associations.
So, Vibenei?
Show.
Aliyah?
Soon.
Rav Kook?
Legend.
Okay, thank you very much, Gini. Eddie.
Can you disappear now?
Sure.
Pababato!
Oh, I'm so sorry, I'm late. Have I missed the time?
You just show us what you would do with that.
So, are you still in the game?
What? FIFA? Yeah, we played Pro Clubs last night.
No, the Omer!
Who's Omer? Like Omer Adam? Tel Aviv, yeah, Habibi, Tel Aviv!
So, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Maybe, I don't know, maybe like Bob the Builder for fixing the halakhic problems of the world.
Genie, can he fix it? Halakha Genie, amen! So, who jumped first into Yam Suf?
I think it was Nachshon Ben Aminadav.
I think we're going to need you to do like an interpretive dance of like what you think the Halacha Gini would look like.
And sure.
So
alright, thanks guys, gotta go. See you later.
Halacha Gini, so good to have it back to our screens, eh?
I wonder who it's gonna be.
Well, I'm really excited. Now, moving on to the show, I genuinely don't know why we're doing this again. So, brace yourself. Here is Karma's Book Club.
Oh no.
Hey
author of Guahava's book clubs for fun.
This week, we're going to be looking at one of my favourites, To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. Come on, let's have a look. Page 99.
Noom, I mean the folks on our street are all old, Jim, and these are only children around here. Mrs. DeBose is close on to 100, and Miss Rachel's old, and so are you, Atticus.
I don't call 50 very old, said Miss Marty tartly. Not been well round yet, now am I?
I'll have Zemo collect him, he said. You haven't forgotten much, Mr. Finch.
Atticus was silent.
Atticus, said Jim.
Yes?
Nothing.
Atticus was a boy just like me.
Well, what a book.
Bloody good is Atticus. I mean, doesn't just everybody want an Atticus?
Yes! Atticus!
Don't say we didn't warn you.
Don't think about it, let's just move on.
Baruch Hashem, I think we have some breaking news.
What?
Josh Feldman appears to be at the scene of the crime. Josh, are you there with, us?
This is Josh Feldman reporting from the scene of the crime. All around Melbourne, there have been hooligans spraying the letters B-I-Y. We have no idea what it means, but it has been stretching all the way from Dandenong all the way back into the CBD. There are some rumours saying that it could mean buzzer is yucky. Others are saying that it probably means barbecue is yummy. But really, we don't know. All we know is that these are possibly part of the biggest crime syndicate in Melbourne's history that are terrorising our neighbourhoods. Make sure that you're keeping your eyes out open for B-I-Y. If you see something, report it. Back to you.
Well, thank you, Josh. That is utterly bizarre.
So weird.
What?
What is B-I-Y?
I don't know. It's like, building Yemen.
Why would it be
built
in Yemen?
I don't know, just moving on. We're having a great time here on the B'nai Show. We'll catch you for a little bit more.
After the end.
Banana boat.
Fun sun protection.
Banana boat.
It's 30 plus.
Banana.
It lasts for hours and hours and hours.
Banana boat.
Good to see us with us.
Now, it's time for a very funky episode of Where Are They Now? Where are they now? They're having such a good time. Hang on, let's give them a call. I said it. Where are they now? Where are they now? I don't want to stop at all.
My name is Avi and I was a madrich in the year 2016.
That's it, 2016 and 2017.
Both of them.
Juniors.
And intermediates.
And seniors.
We got all three, baby.
Triple.
We might tell you a little story about our favourite tochnet.
We once wrote the greatest tochnet B'nai's ever seen. We basically convinced our good friend and third member of the Schnadigans to break his leg.
It was all our idea and not Joel's. I'm in.
Our favourite rough songs are
Gummy Bear,
Hey Bop Biddly Bop,
I Gotta Get Back to My Job,
With a Basketball in My Hand,
I'm a Pizza Man. We're gonna do a bit of Inception.
Hi, I'm on the phone to Rufus. Hold on one second, I'm just doing my interview. Hi, I'm on the phone to Rufus. We're in the middle. You're on it now, basically.
You're in it.
You're in it. You're in
Let's
it.
Let's go. Right. What are we up to these days?
We're both unemployed.
We're
entrepreneurs.
Entrepreneurs in high tech.
Patreon is www.freebananas.
The web stars in high tech agricultural farming. We make corn. Oh, mate! I'm on job.
Avi loves kitchen.
I love kitchen, and if you want to set up a chavruta, I'm in the bases, Abby. In the base on Tuesdays from 8 p.m. What about you?
I do base work from 4 to 6 on Tuesdays.
See you there.
Blast from the past. And now it's time to turn to the future of B'nai Akiva Melbourne.
This week we asked our little ones, do we have free will?
Have you ever had a dream that you want him to do you so much you could do anything?
Do we have free will?
Do we have free will? Do we have free will? What do you think?
Hey Lana, do we have free will?
And do we have free will?
Because you have a body.
What is free will?
When everyone's friends.
Do we have free will? Don't know what it is? Any idea?
Do we have free will?
Do we have free will?
I think we do.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Izzy? Do we have free will?
Well, you heard it here first. Don't say we didn't tell ya.
You're so cute. I'm such fresh minds.
Now, let's end off the show like we always do, with a giggle. Here you go, Shim.
I'm always in traffic with the lame expert. You know this type of person? Constantly... I was a little bit ahead of you. Now we're zooming over here.
Any kind of physical test, I get super competitive. I remember one time I took one of those hearing tests. I tried to listen really, really hard on this hearing test. I wanted to do so well on this hearing test. I don't know what I expected. I thought maybe one of them would come up to me afterwards and say, "What you have is super hearing." What you heard was a piece of cotton touching felt. These results are unbelievable. We're taking a camera. You're going to be the president.
Oh shimmy, 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 shimmy. Oh, too good. Well, Simmy, I think we're out of time here at the Benet Show. And I've had a really good time. Have you had a good time?
I've had a great time.
But now it's time for some
announcements.
We have an absolutely humongous month coming up. Tell them why, Sim.
Keep your eyes peeled for some amazing chesed initiatives. Hashtag
together apart. Yeah, looks like we're out of time here, but we'll be back on the air soon. We don't know how soon.
Not too soon.
Wish us luck, but follow us on Instagram, follow us on Facebook. More importantly, subscribe to us on YouTube and you won't miss us next time we see you. We'll see you next time on The Benet Show.
La vie vous semble grise, 24 heures suffisent pour qu'on la trouve exquise. Que faut-il simplement? Il faut bien.